We're going to play some music for you. Can't call it bluegrass exactly and not full time exactly, but it'll fit the bill. This tune we're going to start off with is a tune Noah wrote called Tumbleweed.
Thank you.
I've got an old-time tune for you here, one that you probably know called Been All Around This World. Said I'm going up on a mountain, that's where I'll take my stand. Pistol in my pocket and a rifle in my hand. I've been all around this world. So take me off, hang me, and all the dead and I'm gone. Said hang me, oh hang me, I'm now dead and gone. It's not the hanging that I'm in, oh it's laying in the jail stone. I've been on the ring this world. That new railroad, but it could relieve. Said I'm working on that new railroad, and mud's up to my knees. Working for Big John Henry, well, he's so hard to please. I've been all around this world. So it's hang me or hang me, all the dead are gone. It's not the hanging that I mind, oh, it's laying in the jail so long. I've been around this world. Yeah, mama and papa and little sister makes three. Said mama and papa and little sister makes three. They've come to see me hanging from the ghetto street. I've been around this world. So it's hang me or hang me, and all the dead are gone. Hang me or hang me, and all the dead are gone. It's not the hanging that I'm at. I've been all around this world. I've I started playing banjo when I moved to Southern California to go to school about 5 years ago. And Topanga was one of the first festivals I competed at, jammed at, and so it's just a real honor to be out here and play for y'all. At the cutting ground, so to speak. This next tune is a tune we wrote for the purpose of being used as a score in a film, but we like it better as just a tune to play. It's called Kathy at the Lake. Thank you. Thanks much. Well, we're going to go ahead and play some of our favorite old-time bluegrass tunes in the set also. Because we're here. So this is a great old-time tune. Pretty endemic of old-time music in that it features murder and the eating of chicken. So go judge for yourself what times you like. All right. This one's called Riley and Spencer. Thanks so much. I'm going to put my picks back on and retune my banjo while Noah introduces the next tune.
How's everyone doing in here? Good to hear it. Good to hear it. This is also my first bluegrass festival that I ever went to, and so I'm really glad to, a couple years later, after showing up and having no idea what I'm doing at all, to be playing on the railroad stage. It's actually a huge honor for me, and I'm really glad to be here. Thanks so much. For this next one, this is a song that took Casey and I quite a while to figure out the name for, because, you know, for stuff like Riley and Spencer and, like, you know, old-time and bluegrass tunes, you know, you have words. But if it's an instrumental, it's a little bit trickier, especially if it's instrumental for banjo and bass. It makes things a little bit more difficult, as you might imagine. So this next one, after a lot of heated debate with more than a little bit of drinking whiskey and yelling at each other in the living room of my apartment, we eventually landed on Coffee on the Porch, because we really think it's sort of, I don't know, it fit, it made sense. We just kept shouting nouns, and coffee was the first one that stuck, and porch was the second one, so here we are. Thank you.
Now, does this count as a porch or a platform?
I don't know.
played in a bluegrass band at UCLA, the UCLA Bluegrass Hoppers. You can't actually call it that. It's the Bluegrass Hoppers. We're not allowed to use the UCLA now. We can get in trouble. We're no longer part of that band, so what's the matter? Hey, and now we play two-fifths bluegrass music. But if anyone, I mean, this is a hip crowd, so people probably know Vern Williams here, or know of Vern Williams. Yeah, a couple people out there. This is one that he did that, he's my favorite bluegrass singer out there, so check him out if you get an opportunity, and a Californian, an imported Californian from Arkansas to boot. One of the first guys playing bluegrass out in California. And he does a great version of this tune, and so we worked it out. It's called the Montana Cowboy. Things can get a little funny because the bass likes certain things and the banjo likes other things. They work well on different features of musicality, and Noam wrote a song, a fiddle tune for bass, and gave it to me, a banjo player, and I had my way with it and sent it back, and it didn't resemble the original piece anymore, but that's what a banjo will do. There's life pre-banjo and life post-banjo, and I'm living it, and I can tell you, post-banjo is rough. Alright, this is a tune called The Jackrabbit. Thank you. made a request.
We did have a request.
Someone requested we play our arrangement of the tune Rain and Snow.
Yeah!
So it's happening.
Yeah.
I don't know if someone's happy in their relationship or a little sad, but
yeah, they had a reason.
This is a song about spousal abuse, so it's an odd request.
Let me have a cold rain.
I hope you're feeling better. Well, we've got two more tunes for you. In the bluegrass vein, I think we're going to go right ahead and play another fiddle tune called Salt Creek. This is the two-person bluegrass band arrangement of this tune. Thanks so much for listening. A couple of the tunes we played today, quite a few of them, are on an EP that we recorded last year, which we have with us. So if you've enjoyed the music, come talk to us afterwards. We'd be happy to send you home some CDs. Right Other Festivals coming up this summer. If you're in Northern California, we'll be playing a good old-fashioned bluegrass festival. And we'll be at the Sutter Creek Jug Band Festival. We'll be out at Rocky Grass in Colorado if you want to head out there.
Yeah.
So the next song I wrote while I was in Sweden. I was traveling after I graduated from school and was in Sweden visiting family, meeting some family, and exploring that connection, family connection. Went to a Swedish music festival, which is like a very similar scene to what's happening right here, except that it's all Swedish music being played, so everyone's got fiddles and accordions and nickel harpas and weird keyed string instruments that you've probably never seen before. Lots of fun stuff, and their jams are like 60 fiddlers standing in a circle and just playing all together. It's just a blast. Anyway, I wrote this tune. I fell in love with a Swedish fiddler. Well, I became enamored with one, I should say. And I went to bed and I had a dream that we got married. And the next day I woke up and went to see her again and she didn't remember my name. So it didn't work out. But I left the festival feeling a bit sad and went home and to my hostel and got on the internet and saw that two of my friends are getting married. So I was like, well, this is kind of weird. And I wrote them a Swedish wedding march in the traditional style. So this tune is called Brudmarsch efter Jack och Ida. And we're going to follow that in a medley with a tune called The Spider Dance that we wrote. Thank you. Well, got one more tune for you. This tune's called Zoe. Thanks so much for listening.